RFK Jr. will appear on Wisconsin's presidential ballot even after suspending his campaign last week. 12 News political director Matt Smith joining us now. And Matt, this kind of help us sort this all out.
Yeah, so RFK Jr.'s campaign even asking, he urged state election officials to keep his name off the ballot after dropping out and endorsing former President Donald Trump. But that's not going to happen. The commission citing state law, essentially forcing their hand, they said, to keep Kennedy's name on the ballot, a point of contention this afternoon for the Wisconsin Elections Commission.
This is a troubling thing for me.
If they have requested to be off the ballot before it's printed, why cannot we honor their request to be off the ballot?
He filed the nomination papers. He appears to qualify. The only way he gets to not be on the ballot is to up and die, which I'm assuming he has no plans of doing. So he has to be put on the ballot.
All right, so in total, 8 candidates will appear on Wisconsin's presidential ballot, the 5 major party nominees, including Kamala Harris and Donald Trump. And here are those 3 independent candidates, including RFK Jr. and Cornell West. Deanna.
A lot to take in right now, Matt. Back to these RFK Jr. developments. What's the impact here in Wisconsin?
So that's the million-dollar question tonight, and whether Wisconsin voters would still vote for him. Before dropping out in Marquette's poll a few weeks ago, RFK Jr. was receiving around 6% among likely voters. That's incredibly high for a third-party candidate. But even if a fraction of people voted for him, it could impact the race.
All right. All eyes on Election Day. Political Director Matt Smith, live in the newsroom.